I can help the Queen with whatever she needs to ready her for her wedding night.
What is it?
The border towns have been swayed.
How? Without the Vatican's support?
The gold and silver, jewels and trinkets, all the wedding gifts you received. At first I thought I would need to use them to placate the nobles in the event that the wedding didn't happen. But once it did, I had them melted down and delivered en masse to the border, a gift from their queen.
Catherine, you are brilliant.
Not as brilliant as you. As your wedding to Darnley. An unworthy husband, to be sure, but the right man to wed. Nearly a dozen more English towns have turned.
Turned? To Scotland?
They have declared themselves part of your kingdom. You have drawn the might of Catholic nations to your side, even as you have sown tolerance. And in taking a king, you have given the people the promise of an heir. Stability, something even Elizabeth's staunchest supporters now no longer believe she will provide.
Still, I can't believe it. More than a dozen towns turned so fast.
People love you, Mary. You have earned their love from the moment you have returned home. And now we must say goodbye. The people have gathered along the corridor to your chambers. Darnley went there directly.
I heard. Because I am queen, I could dismiss the viewing of the consummation, and there won't be one. You and I both know there's no need. God willing, I will never have to lay with that man again.
Understood. Make an excuse tonight and feign illness tomorrow, and then embark on trips away from court. And when you return, tell him you're pregnant, making sex out of the question. But Mary, you cannot live the life of a nun.
As you said, I will have love in my life. Being a mother, a queen, it will be more than enough.
It isn't. Take it from me. And even in my youth, my heart didn't beat as strongly as yours. It will drive you to seek the love of another beyond the affection you bear your child. Be careful.